Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to learn how to play Free Fire Max on PC using the latest version of BlueStacks 5 with Android 11 support, which will allow us to play Free Fire Max at 120fps and more, and we can save up to 75% in RAM usage, which will allow you to play Free Fire Max on a low-end PC. We will be able to easily download and install Free Fire Max and enjoy the game on our Windows PC making use of keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which at present is the only emulator that supports Android 11. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all my friends, to start we need to launch our favorite browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to the current URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type it, simply because I added a link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed on this page on the site of Usitility, in which we have a nice precise explanation on how to obtain Free Fire Max on laptop or computer. We scroll lower a tad and press on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to the game Free Fire Max on PC. Safest, secure and most reliable Android gaming platform, BlueStacks is an American gaming company that takes data privacy very seriously. As you can discover from here we get some advantages of preferring using that emulator. Now we are on the way to start downloading the Free Fire Max by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. Next step is clicking on this button. And the download takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It is a file to execute. What we are going to do now is to run the executable file, okay, then we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the system. We answered yes. I minimize the web browser to start to see the installation software significantly better. The installer is pretty simple. It is made up of two choices, install, and setup path. I will clarify what setup path does. We basically just simply click on it. And we discover that we end up with here the path where the emulator is going to be put in. If we choose to modify this directory we have got to click on that browse option, and therefore we select another directory and set up the emulator specifically where we wish. I am going to set it by default. Then, I click on back. And I just click on install. Now, there it is. The install begins and it is going to carry on along with the download of those MB that are shown on our computer screen. After you save it on your hard disk, it could be more or less MB. The download speed can be faster or slower, depending on your internet and according to the speed capacity of the emulator servers. At the moment they are working incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. Thanks to BlueStacks, you can now run Android 11 and play your favorite games at 120fps and more. Additionally, you can save up to 75% of RAM usage. This is great news for gamers with lower spec PCs. BlueStacks expects to release more powerful updates with Android 11. Follow them on social media to stay up to date with more information. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has actually been started on autopilot. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right when it actually reaches the end, the emulator will be started for the first time. In reality the emulator is already started, here for the first time. Before we start downloading the game, we must install BlueStacks Android 11 version. For this purpose we will click on the icon located here on the right. We click on the icon and the BlueStacks Multi-Instance Manager will be launched. Here we have the BlueStacks Multi-Instance Manager. What we are going to do is to create a new emulator instance. For that, we click on this instance icon. In this new instance window, we can create a new instance or clone an existing one. We are going to create a new instance. To do so, click on the Fresh Instance option. In this window we must choose the Android version for the new instance. Click on the drop-down menu and we will see all the Android versions we can choose from. We are going to select this option that says Android 11. Once the Android version is selected, we click on the Next button. In this window we must configure the new instance specifications. I am going to choose 4 CPU cores, 4 GB of memory allocation, landscape resolution of 1600x900, and in the performance I am going to choose High Performance. We click on the Download button. And the new BlueStacks instance with Android 11 installed will start downloading. It will download a few hundred megabytes, so depending on your internet connection, it will take more or less time. For us, the download went pretty fast. Now the new instance is being created. This will take more or less time depending on our PC capabilities. Now we must stop the BlueStacks instance that was launched by default. To do this we must click on the Stop button above. We confirm that we want to close the instance by clicking on the Close button located in the pop-up window. We see that there is no BlueStacks instance launched, so let's proceed to launch the Android 11 instance by clicking on the Start button. The BlueStacks Android 11 instance is just starting to execute. It is getting ready to be launched. It may take a while in this case. Now BlueStacks emulator is launching with Android 11 version, so things are getting closer to be able to enjoy our favorite games at 120fps and have a very low use of our PC's RAM memory. Let's make the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and which is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we'll mouse click on Play Store. As you can discover, the Google Play is presented. At this point we have got to log on. At this moment, the moment we're right here, we have to begin doing the next step that is imperative. So that we simply click on Sign In. Now it announces, checking info. It might occasionally get blocked in checking info, and so it isn't going to move ahead. If so, you should attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours, but it will surely most certainly be fixed. Now we shall provide our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email address and its corresponding password. For instance, you can utilize the very same email you are using at this moment in your own YouTube account. Then I will enter my information and I will come back as soon as I have accomplished it. That's it, information typed. And here is Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We are going to consent to them all by just pressing, I agree. Next, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also let it select it, it's going to produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. Okay, I am right into Google Play. What we are going to accomplish will be go here to search for apps and games. And consequently we're going to locate Free Fire Max. Generally there we get it, we can click the first result. Here we access to the Android game. How about we press right here on the install link that I am highlighting now in green color. And it will initiate the software setup. Presently it would download and install the video game, it might take quite some time or perhaps it might well be extremely fast. This all varies on the internet access. It's already ended installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this specific option that I'm showing in green, so that you can run Free Fire Max for the first time. We are currently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to just click on that new Free Fire Max icon that was provided. The Android game is started for the first time. Now there we get it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. Now, to be sure that we are going to enjoy Free Fire Max at maximum performance, we must click here on the cogwheel. And the emulator configuration screen will open. We must go to the performance option, and here be sure that we have chosen CPU allocation, high, 4 cores, memory allocation, high 4 GB, performance mode, high performance. Then we enable the option, enable high frame rate. Now we see that the option to increase the FPS is enabled. So let's set the FPS to 120. We click on it, and we finally have the FPS setting at 120. We could set more if our PC is powerful enough. Now just click the Save Changes button and restart the emulator to start enjoying Free Fire Max to the fullest. And to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is simply the first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon which I am actually pointing out in green color. And the display screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In case we aspire to have fun with the application using all the screen, we press on this particular app icon. And we might presently be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen setting. To get out of the full screen mode, hit the F11 key. And we might now play in regular display setting. Now I am ready to demonstrate to you the computer keys mapping that is really quite appealing. This step we definitely will be ready to make use of the video game much more effortlessly. The first point is to click on this software icon. It's now time to complete the recommended configuration settings. Let me put the default configuration, however if you plan to improve that, you can also achieve it without having problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. On occasion it occurs that your emulator is started in the improper language, as an example, in Chinese. And consequently to set it up in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. And right here inside of many other options, we just click on the language drop-down. We can easily opt for the language we want, German, Mandarin, and so on. After the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will reboot, and the game application, the next time we launch it, would also be in the preferred language. At this moment, you will find another point that we have to take into consideration, and it's that we will get a message from Gmail saying that a completely new electronic device has been associated with our Google account. It should check with us if we're the individuals who have associated with that device. That's right, we shouldn't worry, considering the fact that emulator is emulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And to identify which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And we browse here to the model selection. And now we notice that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our video tutorial. I anticipate you enjoyed it, particularly that you thought it was informative. In that case, offer it a great thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, concerns or suggestions, put them in the comment area below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams on occasion. You have it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Click on any of those video tutorials which are usually appearing on the suggestion of videos to watch, and let's have fun again in the following video tutorials. Bye.